Soundings Audiobooks presents an unabridged recording of On a Making Tide, written by David Donaghy, read by Jonathan Keeble. The moral right of the author has been asserted. Prologue, 1771. His boots were wet, and the dew that clung to the Norfolk marsh grass had soaked both his stockings and the bottoms of his white breeches. As he was small, Horatio Nelson had to push hard to open the door, and its creaking hinges added to the eeriness of his errand. The pews of the chapel at Burnham Thorpe were empty, while the bare stone walls of the interior, open to the elements at the south nave, ensured that on this March morning it was even colder inside the chapel than out. He shivered as he approached the black marble slab that lay to the left of the nave, and stepped round the bronze outline of the knight buried centuries before. He felt somehow that this was a fateful moment. He knelt between the two graves and put his hands together in prayer, his lips moving silently as he asked a blessing on his future. His mind was full of images of himself and his mother. He could see her now, on the day they had gone to King's Lynn to visit the Tableau Vivant, based on the painting by Benjamin West, detailing the death of General James Wolfe, his life sacrificed in far-off Canada in the battle to capture Quebec City. Muffled music, heavy with the deep beat of the funeral drum, had played in the background. Wolfe lay in the arms of his officers, and the regimental flags held over his head were limp and tattered, ripped asunder by shot and shell, stained with mud. But the Union flag of Great Britain showed red, white, and blue above them all, extended so that the entire world should know that here, on the plains of Abraham, Albion had triumphed over Gaul.